Hi everyone, this is Ala. So in this tutorial, I want to show you how to connect your Cisco router to your ISP home router and connect through it. So here we go. First, I have a Cisco router 2600 series. It can be any router, by the way. And I have a switch, a Catalyst switch, 24 ports, 2950. So first, I have made the connection through a console cable, and here we have two fast Ethernet ports. Port 1, port fast 00, will be the one that we will connect to our home ISP router, and the fast Ethernet 01 will be the one which will connect my internal devices to the outside world. So here I have set up the serial connection since I'm connecting via laptop, so I don't have a serial connector. That's why I had to put a serial to USB, and I'm using PuTTY on Linux. I wonder if you can see. Sorry, it's a bit, here are dev.tty USB zeros on a Linux. Okay, here we go. Let's start. Okay, so it's asking me to enter my console password, which I will do. So here we come to the interface, to the prompt of our router. If you can see, it has a greater than sign, which is the default mode. It's not the privileged mode. To enter the privileged mode, I type EN or enable. And then it's asking me for my password for the privileged mode. Okay, there we go, great. So first, I'll have to do a set of settings actually to make this operation successful. First, let's have a look on my running config, show run. So as you can see here, it shows the password is in secret, so it's encrypted. Fast Ethernet 00, no IP address. And fast Ethernet 01, no IP address. Great. Okay. So I apologize, guys, for the output actually, because I'm trying my best to record with one hand and work with the other hand. Okay, first, let's go and set up our router, our interface, sorry. So we're in the config mode. Config T stands for config terminal. So INT. FA 00. IP address DHCP. For this one, I'm planning to let this interface grab dynamic IP address from the home ISP router. No shut. And at the same time, I'm gonna set this interface to be my NAT outside interface, because we'll be using the NAT to allow the hosts in the private network, in the internal network, to go outside. We need the NAT, so IP NAT outside. Great. Now let's go to interface, FA, fast Ethernet 01. For this one, I will give it an IP address in the range of 172.16.1.1, 255.255.255.0. This will be the default gateway for the internal network. No shut. IP NAT inside. Great. So we have our interfaces already set up. As you can see, now I did exit to return to the global config mode. Now I will set up a default IP address that will be used for the internal traffic to allow connecting to outside with the NAT. So I'm gonna give the default gateway of my outside ISP home router, and of course I'm gonna set a DHCP pool that will be used for my internal hosts IP DHCP pool. I will name it home, for example, network 172.16.1.0 255.255.255.0 default router, which is my default gateway, is the address for the interface FA01, and DNS server to resolve the hosts. I will give the Google public DNS server. Okay, great. I will make an exclusion actually for the IP DHCP, exclude the addresses, so to make sure the DHCP server will not lease the IP address of the router. So I will exclude the first 10, 1 through 10. Okay, great. So now, in order to achieve the NAT, we have to create an IP access list. So let's see if it accepts the new, okay, IP access list. If we do question mark, it gives you the options. I'm going to choose a standard access list, and you can give a word. You can choose a number, and also you can give a word. Let's choose just a number, one, to make things easier. So now it takes us to a sub-config for the NAT to determine which one, what network, what address range we want to permit. So in this case, I'm gonna permit 172.16.1.0 0.0.0.255, the wildcard mask. And now let's create our NAT. IP NAT inside source list. This is to stress out that this is a dynamic NAT, not a static NAT. List one, the one we just created. Interface fast Ethernet 0.0. We get a point to the outside, and overload to allow multiple hosts through this NAT. Okay, I think we're good. Is there something we forgot to do? So I'm gonna do show run. Let's see how our config looks like right now. Okay, so let's look Let's see how our config looks like. We have our DHCP pool, we have our DHCP exclude addresses. As you can see, we have the network 172.16.1.0. The default router is the interface, the IP interface of Fast Ethernet 01, and the DNS is the public DNS for Google. And what we have else? Okay. FA00 will grab an IP address from the home ISP router to which it will be connected. IP, we have the IP NAT outside. What about the FA01? Okay, looks good. So the gateway is the one that's pointing to my home ISP router, and we have our NAT here and our default route, and here is our access list to permit only traffic from this internal network, nothing else. We should be good. Great. So now I'll pause the video actually until I do the patching, the cabling setup, and I should return back soon. Okay, so here we have done the setup. As you can see, this is my home ISP router. As you can see, this gray cable, okay, you see some activity, there's a light flashing, that means that there is some traffic. So I connected this one to Fast Ethernet of my router. Sorry, I wonder if you can see. Yes, here it is. So it's Fast Ethernet 01. See screen. And from my router, Fast Ethernet 01, I connected the cable to the first port of a switch. And then from a switch, I have here a cable coming here into my computer. Now, let's turn on my computer and see which address we'll get. So even my other laptop is a Linux, by the way. And as you can see here, the lights on the switch are green on the two ports that are connected. Means everything is good, up and running, traffic is going through. Okay, just bear with me, waiting for this to come up. Okay, it's finally in. Okay, stop it. So here, if you look, it doesn't show the wireless, show connected to the wired network. Let's see what IP address I'm getting. Okay, so in Linux it's if config. And here you go. See that? 172.16.1.11. Let's see if we can get some traffic. I'm gonna disable the Wi-Fi just to make sure, because I saw it picked up a Wi-Fi address, although it's not supposed to. Okay, so now we are sure that we have only our connection through a cable, our Ethernet connection. As you can see, there's no WLO anymore for the wireless. And we're still getting our 172.16.1.11. Let's see if we can get outside. Open Mozilla. Let's open YouTube, for example. And yes, we can get into YouTube, no problem. What about other website? Say something that I don't visit quite often, CNN.com. Yes, we're able to get in. That's great. And now, let's see something else. I do have an IPTV, okay? Now it's connected right now, actually it's connected to my home router via cable. So let's see the settings. Where are they? Tools, probably, or menu, sorry, menu. I'll go here to network, probably network settings. No, sorry, it's not that. So I'll go to network status then. Network status. So we'll check the network status and let me know. Great. So if I go here to IP settings, guess what? I have an address within the range of my internal network, of my ISP internal network, 192.168.0.13. So now let's see what will happen if I connect it to my switch. Let's do it. Take this out, this one. Okay. So here we go. We'll put it in number 3, for example. And since I have enabled the port fast, as you can see, it turned green quickly because I don't have any other switch. So there is no need to keep the spanning tree open. I mean, it's open, but I enabled the port fast actually to have the interface come up quickly. Okay, now after it turned green, let's see what we get. Let's retry. It's connected. IP settings. Yes! 172.16.1.12. And if you remember, I've given the DNS of Google. As you can see, it's there. So now, I'm gonna cancel it. I will see if I can get any traffic. Let's open our smart hub. I'm gonna exit from this one. Let's go to YouTube. And yes, I'm connected. Let's open cartoons for my kids. And yes, we have here. Here we are. Babies are us. Okay. I think we're good. We're done. So I hope you enjoyed this listen and you found it helpful. Thank you very much for watching. Have a good day.